Good evening. This is Pastor Stephen Brown bringing you greetings from Duncanville, Texas. This is Greater Bethlehem Baptist Church, our Wednesday night Bible study. And I'm so grateful to have each of you here this evening sharing with us and just spending a little time with us. Hey, as we prepare to get started, if you feel led, please go ahead and click the share button, start a watch party. This is our Wednesday night where we just kind of hang out for 10, 15 minutes. We're not going to hold you long. Want to give you something simple, practical, and powerful in a very succinct amount of time. So grab your scriptures, phone somebody, let someone know that we're getting ready to get started. And as you do that, I'm going to offer us up a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we are so grateful for this day. We thank you for the season that we're in because you've taught us in your word to give thanks in all seasons. So we trust you, we love you, we honor you, and we simply ask that you would move in the midst of what we're doing on this evening. Father, thank you for Greater Bethlehem. Thank you for the witness that we are in the East Dallas area. And we give you glory, praise, and honor just for who you are. In Christ's name we pray. Everybody say amen. Come on, say amen again. Well, listen, we have been in a series called Family Matters, and we hope that you have had a chance to participate in some of the things that we've been doing. We've spoken to issues related to the family in the midst of this kind of weird quarantine season. We opened up with Good Times, kind of throwback to our 1970s hit Good Times. And in that message and series of messages, we dealt with the lessons of contentment. We're learning that you can't always have your own way. And so this season of shelter in place has taught us to be content. Then secondly, we move to the Golden Girls. We love the Golden Girls, y'all. And these silver stars taught us the value of not overlooking those who have gone before us. And this is so easy for us to happen. We can get busy and preoccupied with self that we forget those who have paved the way before us. Then on this past Sunday, we dealt with parents just don't understand. Hey, that old Will Smith and Jazzy Jeff hit. And in there, we looked at Luke 15, the prodigal son story and narrative where the Lord Jesus is teaching us about lost things. And in that, we learned about this young man's impatience. But we also learned about a father's love and how a father's love releases. So today, we're going to follow up with that and deal with Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. As you prepare to find Ephesians 6, 1 through 4, I want to share a few more things. Number one, you may say, well, Pastor, I don't have any more kids in the house. Hey, if you don't have any kids in the house still, you may have grandkids, you may have neighborhood kids, nieces and nephews. This is applicable to everybody. Parents, you may say, well, my kids are okay, and I think I'm doing great. Praise God. Let's keep learning and let's keep developing on what the Lord is doing in and through the ministry of your home. So Ephesians 6, I'm going to look down here and read verses 1 through 4 of Ephesians chapter 6. Listen to the word of the Lord. Children, obey your parents in the Lord because this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with the promise, so that it may go well with you and that you may have long life in the land. Fathers, don't stir up anger in your children, but bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. Y'all, we're going to talk this evening from the topic, and that I love this topic. Here it is. Happy home. Oh God, somebody say happy home. Come on, happy home. Here is the big idea that I want to share with you, and I want you to know, embrace, and believe this. And that is, peace is possible. Peace is possible. Yes, it is. Peace is possible. So on Sunday, we kicked off this kind of difficult topic, dealing with parents relating to young people and young people relating to parents. And I realized that as we dealt with this issue of parenting and being a child or a student or a teenager, the issues of peacemaking and reconciliation came to the forefront. But here is the thing. Some of you may be thinking again, you know, Pastor, I don't have any kids. And watch this. These principles go beyond parenting, because there is a tension that many of us have experienced in our homes during the shelter in place, where, let me tell you something, if you don't learn some key peacemaking principles and how to be reconciled during this season of life, then, hey, you're going to miss out on a tremendous blessing. We're all going to have conflict. We're all going to have tension, be it parenting, spouse, it doesn't matter. You're going to have tension. And if we don't learn how to adapt and adjust and address these issues, beloved, things are going to blow up and get even worse in the midst of our family relationship. So some of us can honestly admit that we've never been around our spouses or our children this much, ever. And so we're in this season where really the struggle is real. And if I were to be honest, you know, if getting on my wife's nerves was a place, I stay there. I'm doing something almost two or three times a day that just wears her thin. And so we have to be honest and just keep it real. The struggle is real. We are bumping into each other. The house is only so big. The backyard is only so big. And so if we have to really embrace this season, parent, children, parent, and spouses. So let's dig in. Ephesians chapter six, it opens up verses 1-4 with essentially two words. Let me give you these two words. Real simple. The two words are honor and obedience. Honor and obedience. Honor and obedience. Listen to the text again. I'll read it in your hearing. He says, children, obey your parents. Then it says, honor your father and your mother. It's amazing how these two themes of honor and obedience come to the forefront of what Paul is communicating. So let's unpack those for just a moment to make sure we're on the same page. Honor is literally to hold in high regard, to hold in high regard, to cherish their very being. And it's so important at this stage in life, young people, that you really get a handle of what that looks like, to hold in high regard, to cherish. Then the second one is obedience. Obedience means, at its very root, to listen to, watch this, and to do. Let me say that again. Obedience is to listen well, even better, and to do. Two very strong, very simple virtues I want you to get. Honor and obedience. Young people, these two virtues, if you allow them to, will really help our homes to be places of peace, happy homes. And if we were to track most of the conflict and the tension that we experience in our homes, very likely they are traced back to dishonor. Now, that's not just parent and child, that's spouses. Dishonor, where you don't cherish, where you don't value an individual at the level or the way that they deserve. And here's the thing about honor. You honor people the way they want to be honored. You hold them in regard in the manner that they, it doesn't matter what you want for them. That's part of it. But what's ultimately the big deal is what they need from you. Oh, married couples. I told you there's some rollover stuff in here for you as well. So we got to really embrace this value of honoring each other. And so when I honor someone, I instinctively cherish them in such a way that I seek to meet needs and to make a difference. That's crucial, y'all. I seek to meet needs and make a difference. So, and what Paul is saying to the believers at Ephesus as he addressed this home and this whole home, he's like, listen, children and parents, there's some shared responsibility as it relates to honoring and obeying. So parents and kids, obedience is most effective, watch this, where there is a clear establishment of God-ordained honor and respect. I need you to get that. Paul said, listen, young people, this is right. What I'm commanding you and challenging you to do is right. Oh, I'm sweating, y'all. He said, what I'm commanding you and telling you to do is right. This is right. So young people, you're not obeying and honoring your parents just to make them happy. You're doing it because it glorifies God. You're doing it because it brings honor to God. So obedience and honor is not limited to your parents' house. So wherever you go in life, you carry that with you. It is a blessing to your parents. Y'all remember on Sunday, we gave three hooks to help all of us in our familial relationships. Here they are. Roles, responsibilities, and responses. Roles, responsibilities, and responses. I'm going to leave it on screen for just a moment. Roles, responsibilities, and responses. So he opens up by challenging us. He said, listen, children, I need for you all to do your part in obeying mom and dad, grandma, whoever your guardian is. Make sure that you're honoring and obeying them as a symbol of respect, demonstrating it in such a way that you give them what they need. And there are some longevity principles and promises attached to that. Need you to catch that. And then he goes on to verse 4. He said, now, fathers, I'm talking to you now. Parents, fathers, mothers, don't stir up anger in your children, but bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. So if we're honest, parents, we tend to go off when we feel dishonored. We tend to go off when we feel dishonored. An assignment is blown. A direct order is not fulfilled. I like this one. A set of eyes is rolled. That eye roll will get you on it. And so as a consequence, when we feel dishonored, that's when we have a tendency to retaliate. And so when you match dishonor with an already tense season, like we're in shelter in place, we're missing work. We're missing wages. We've lost some freedom. Homeschooling, home working, home living, all of those are colliding together. Y'all, you will not have a happy home. There will be constant clashing. So here it is, beloved. I'm going to give you two principles, not even three. I'm going to give you two. Even though I'm Baptist, I'm going to give you two tonight. Here's the first one I want you to grab. Parents, you must process this mess. As a matter of fact, that's parents and children. Process this mess. Parents and kids, your first step in this, and really the singular step in this, is to begin to have the conversation. Begin to have the conversation. See, I need young people to just kind of hear me. And that may not be in there with you now. You can let them listen to it later. But here's how parents see young people. You're at home, but you're typically plugged in. Stop me when I'm lying, y'all. I shouldn't say lying. Stop me when I'm telling the story, y'all. Yeah, you're home, but you're plugged in. You're engaged in other spaces and places. Here's another one. You hardly talk to them. I'm talking to the young people now. The only time you speak is when spoken to. Here's another one. You always seem a bit agitated when your parents or your guardian, your grandmother, whomever, ask you a question. It's never the right time to ask you a question. Oh, God, I'm feeling this by myself. Here's another one. You talk at them, not to them. Wow, that's real, young people. That's real. And so as a consequence to all of that, you know, there is just not much effective communication taking place. Now, parents, I started with them, but I got to deal with you for just a moment. Here's what kids see. That they never quite measure up to your expectations, regardless of what they are. It's never quite up to their standard. Here's another one. You're frequently upset over what happened out there. And somehow, some way, that level of upsetness makes its way in here. And that's the only time that they really see you engage with them is when you're upset. And the only time you really display love, parents, is after you've blown up. So you've blown up, you've flown off the handle. Things got a little crazy and chaotic. And then you settle in your spirit and get convicted by the Lord. And then you want to go and hug him and love him and kiss him. And so that sort of schizophrenic engagement between parents and kids, this is what creates this unusual tension. Y'all, we have to begin the conversation. If we're going to process this mess, we got to begin to have the conversation. Let me give you some more principles that I want you to just flow with me. Just flow in this spirit that we're in right now. Here's something I want you to work on. Tell me how you feel today. That needs to be communicated, both parent and child. Watch this. That even can go over with spouses. Tell me how you feel today. Here's another one. Tell me what troubles you about the season that we're in. Parents, have you even stopped to ask your child, your children, how they're dealing with this whole shelter in place, not being able to go back to school, having to work from home with you in the house, very likely, you know, all the things that they're dealing with. Tell me what troubles you about this season that we're in. Here's another one. Tell me what you think is troubling me. I like that one. That gives you the opportunity to see how you've been communicated either non-verbally or verbally. They get to interpret what they think you're dealing with. Here's another one. Let's begin praying about our feelings. That's a wonderful season for devotion. Let's just pray about how we've been feeling. But here's the last one. Let's find some scriptures that speak to those feelings. Y'all, let me give you this slide again. When you take the time to process this mess, you begin to have effective conversations. Oh, God, process this mess. But I'm almost finished. Here's a second principle. Not only must you process this mess, secondly, we have to pass the test. Oh, God, I like this by myself. Somebody say pass. Come on, say pass. Pass the test. Pass the test. I'm going to begin with the young people again. Young people, here's the deal. Your destiny is directly connected to the honoring of your parents. Your destiny. I don't care what it is you want to do in life. It is connected to your honoring of your parents. And so I want you to understand that there is a promise that is connected to this principle. And it was first introduced way back in the Old Testament. Exodus chapter 20. Listen to it. Want to hear it? Here it go. Exodus 20:12 says, honor your father and your mother, so that you may have a long life in the land that the Lord, your God, is giving you. Young people, you got to pass this test of honor. Your destiny is tied to it. Parents, coming back to you as we wrap up, your latter years are directly connected to the seeds that you plant today. I want to say that one more time. Your latter years are directly connected to the seeds that you plant today. This is why we must all process this mess that we're dealing with so that we can pass this test. If our anger and our frustration pour over into our parenting, our futures will all be dim. And I'm not trying to be overly pessimistic, but I want you to learn the lesson. Remember the first part of this series, we dealt with contentment. You got to learn to be content. Y'all, we got to learn how to honor and to obey kids and to reverence and to cherish and to value. And parents, you got to learn how to love these kids in the way that they want to be loved and to discipline them in a way that will nurture them and to bring them up. Parents, you must learn the lesson of leading with love. There it is, y'all. Leading with love. Let me give you these last few here under the pass the test. Because if you learn to lead with love, you must learn how to love your children the way they desire to be loved. A child is not likely to find a father in God unless he finds something of God in his father or his mother. I'm preaching up in here, y'all. So anyway, the way we're going to pass this test, number one, we're going to pass it with God. That's the only way we're going to pass it. He has to be at the forefront of everything that we do. And then we have to pass it with each other. With each other. Parents, Children, y'all need each other. Husbands, wives, wives, husbands, y'all need each other. We have to do it with each other. And thirdly and finally, we have to pass this test for our future's sake, for the sake of our future. Now, this is real talk. This is so real. And I want to just continue to pray for all of us during this season, because I get the difficulty of what we're all dealing with. This is some craziness, y'all. And if we don't process this mess effectively, biblically, spiritually, prayerfully, if we don't seek to pass the test, whatever our deficiencies and weaknesses are, beloved, I'm telling you, our futures will be dim. But we're not going to go down that road. We're going to make these adjustments. We're going to begin to have these conversations. We're going to create a list of things to pray about and study scriptures to speak to those things. Parents, we're going to watch how we respond, how we demonstrate love in practical ways. Young people, we're going to not be so plugged in and not be so agitated and be willing to engage and meet our parents. Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you so much for your word. Thank you for how you practically lead us in the way that we are to go. Thank you for the examples that you've given us today. Father, roles, responsibilities, and responses. Help us to hide these in our heart. Help us to work on this beginning today, and may we begin to yield dividends on tomorrow. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. All right, before we go, listen, Mother's Day is this weekend. We've been inviting you all to take a 8 to 10 second video telling us about your mom, or you can just send a picture with her name. Send that to N as in Nicole Tarrant, T-A-R-R-A-N-T, Brown, at gmail.com, ntarrantbrown@gmail.com. Send those 8 to 10 second videos. We've gotten some. We need a whole lot more. And let's celebrate our moms this weekend. We're also preparing something special that hopefully we'll get everything solidified and we'll be able to share that with you Sunday morning. All right, y'all. Praise God, and we'll see you soon. Take care.